So hi there everyone, I'm Stephen from Noel Leeming Tech Solutions, and today I've got the really exciting job of doing an unboxing on the Mavic Air. Now this thing's pretty sweet. Straight from the look of it, we've got a very nice tidy white box, but we've got two images on it, so we get to see the new DJI Mavic Air with its fully expanded form on this side, and then we get to see the compactness of it on the back side. So let's get into this thing and have a look. This always makes you feel like a kid at Christmas when you're doing this. Okay, now one thing to note at the top of the box here, if you get one, you get to check that you've got the right color on the top. So there's three color options available. You've got the Arctic White, you've got the Flame Red, and then you've got the Onyx Black. And it does have a little circle underneath each one indicating it, as well as on the side, it even says Arctic White. Right, we're gonna open it up now. So what have we got inside here? First things to take out, I actually think this is the drone itself. That's pretty small, even from the look of it. Inside here, this here tells me this has got some instructions inside of it. Then we've got our cool little controller. What else is in the box? We've got plenty of these little silicone gel things, and the Mavic Air accessories is in this box. And is that it? That's it. The rest of it inside the box is just packaging. So what have we got inside of each of these ones? I don't know where to start. We might actually start with opening up some of the accessory stuff first, and then we'll leave the big fun things till the end. Right, so that's some of the accessories. Then if we have a look, this is our remote. So the remote for it's pretty cool. It's very similar to probably the DJI Mavic Pro, the original one that the Mavic series came out with. And it's quite a neat, compact size. One of the things I notice on here is it hasn't got the screen on it that the DJI Mavic Pro had that showed you some details as you were flying. We get to see, I get to unwrap all of these. Two aerials again on these ones here. They do fold into that nice compact size, so that means it's nice and easy for that travel, and it's very flat. So you see here that the actual thumbsticks themselves get to pop in and out and all get hidden and stored inside the whole unit itself, so it gives it that real flat feel to it. You don't feel anything popping up and getting in the way if it's in a pocket or in a jacket or something like that. Because I know for me, one of the frustrations is ever if those sticks get hit on stuff, you're always wondering, is it going to cause extra damage to them? So then we get to unfold. And so inside here, ordinarily your phone or your very small tablet can go for using the actual drone itself. And we see just in here, this is where our thumbsticks are. So get to take them out and pop them on. So again, it's all about keeping all of the storage stuff right on the drone itself, rather than it having to be put somewhere else. Gives you that full hold it and walk wherever you need to go, look and feel. Now those thumbsticks do just screw in, which is great. And then that's pretty much it for there. Inside here we see we've got the adapter. This one's come pre-set up with the lightning cord adapter cord inside of it. So, let's get into it. Now, I've got to say, as far as a storage container is concerned, I'd feel pretty confident throwing this into almost any bag that I've got. This is a nice feeling, nice, good, sturdy feel to it. It feels very similar to a camera case box or something like that you'd find out and around the place. Zip feels nice and sturdy. It doesn't feel like it's going to jam and stick. And then, wow. Well, look at that. I mean, if you had said to me that the new drone that they were going to bring out would be able to fit in the palm of my hand, I probably would have thought you were having a joke with me. That is amazingly small. And it's really light. Really light. That's actually probably lighter than I was even anticipating. I know it's probably similar to what the Spark feels as far as its weight's concerned, but it is quite a bit lighter than the actual DJI Mavic Pro on it. But this, I can see why they've called it the Mavic Air, because it really is a light feeling drone. So to unfold, that's pretty neat. We've got the battery on the bottom of this one. So you've got a battery indicator here, which we press there. Looks like it comes with no charge in it in the box. Pull back on two side levers there and pull out the battery. Now I've got to say, considering that already had the battery in it, that's really, really light. And we can look at the actual camera itself. Now this has got a really stylish cover on the actual camera cover. The DJI Mavic Pro one has a clip-on gimbal cover as well, but this one feels like it's more compact and definitely part of the unit itself. Unclip the sides, and then it actually slides out from it. And then we get to see that's what that looks like. So there's our camera in the front there. The gimbal's all kind of contained and within the body of the unit itself. We can actually even flick down the legs on the front here. That's pretty neat. So that gives you that elevated look from the front. It means that that's what our drone looks like there. That's a pretty slick looking drone. Now, the other thing we'll have a nosy at is just what else they've put inside here in our instruction pieces. Ah, this is what I was thinking we'd find. Now, DJI likes to make sure that we've got a few extra bits and pieces with our drones. So open everything in the box here. We get lots of instruction manuals. So there's your nighttime reading for you, is to go through those. We've got, it tells us what's in the box, so that's always a good thing to have. And so far we found everything that's inside there. And inside here, we actually get a full set of four blades. So there's actually four extra blades inside here. What else did we find in here? We've got some drone blade protectors. So these here are designed to go on the outside and clip over the actual blades themselves, and just means that you get some protection for it. So if it happens to go next to a bush or a shrub or even into a tree, and let's hope it doesn't, this is going to protect the blades themselves and give a little bit more resilience for it. So I'm way too excited for us to wait too long. So I'm going to go and get this charged up straight away and come back to you with a bit of a flying demo inside the room here of what the drone itself can do. See, it's pretty stable. Really cool and so stable. Like, it took off, it didn't move. There was no movement in there. It wasn't kind of flying stray all over the place. And that's even without a GPS signal, because we are inside. So this is a really neat device. Very easy to use, set up as a breeze. And you know, it's all about getting out there and really flying with the things. Well, thanks guys. It's been my absolute pleasure to take you through this drone today. I may have to take it home for the weekend and give it a bit of a play. Thanks again, and we'll see you next time.